Hello.
Thank you for sliding through, Dark Side family.
Yeah.
I'm Latios Muhammad, an actor with purpose.
And I'm Rita Moon, an actor with passion.
And we are actors
from the dark side.
So what's been going on, Miss Raven?
You know, getting out in this city, living that life. So happy that the pandemic is finally starting to get behind us, minus this Delta variation or whatever people are talking about. So I'm just trying to enjoy life.
Oh, they were talking about that. I'm like over this heat. This heat has been, what the heck is going on in Colorado?
You know, I'm always cursing summer, girl. I'm like, I hate these 3 months. I'm like, I know what's coming. Shoot.
I'm just like, it's never like been Arizona. This hot. It's like 100 and something degrees.
Shoot, yeah. We always get at least a week of 100.
It's but it's been a month.
A little bit.
Yeah, I can't take it. But anyway, so glad to be here. Things are opening up. Everything's popping up here in Denver, Colorado. If you don't know, you're going to know today. Yes.
What are we talking about today?
So we're going to hit a kind of a topic called diversity pacification in TV and film. Kind of just discussing like, hey, we're asking for diversity, inclusion, and equity, and you're giving it to us, but are you really giving it to us? What do you think?
Interesting. Well, I know that we've come a long way since I was a little girl. I don't know if that really means that representation is where it should be, or actually always representing reality, if you will, you know? So yeah, what are your thoughts, Latios?
Yeah, I feel like we've come a long way, but we're still not getting what we need. You know, we kind of had this little conversation one off about just how we're seeing ourselves in film and TV. Yes, we're starting to be more inclusive, and we're starting to get a few lead roles, but how are you presenting us on the TV and screen?
Right.
Yeah. Is it something that reflects our actual background and totality of our heritage, like as we did, you know, a week ago or so, how we did the review, you know, the barrio reflected the Afro-Latin community.
Yes.
Are we getting that same representation for sitcoms and leads and roles and,
that
we can be with our own counterparts.
I feel like we were doing a better job of really kind of paying homage to different cultures and different American cultures, if you will, like when they started producing shows like Blackish and like Off the Boat and even the Goldbergs, right, representing a Jewish family, representing an Asian family, even going back to, what was the comedian name, Robert Rodriguez, he had his own family show,
that was kind of one of the first
Latino families on television, just like Off the Boat. One of the first Asian families that gets to get represented. But boy, that had to happen beyond 2000. And now I almost feel like there's a real rush to do the blended family, right? To do like the mixed dish and things like that. What do you think, Latios, you know?
There is a rush. There's so many. I feel like sometimes, yes, they're being very inclusive. They're giving us lead roles, but how are you giving us lead roles to do so? I guess for me, okay, so for an instance, Sistas, my favorite show. I love that show. Now it's five, beautiful, successful women, okay? And then there's one who is actually dating a white guy. Okay, now what I love about Tyler Perry, he's going to make sure that white guy looks good. He is gorgeous. Don't get me wrong. But now the thing is that still the subliminal message is all of the brothers that are dating the sisters
They low down, huh?
Yeah, something wrong with them.
Ooh, I hate
someone
that.
got a criminal
that
record.
Gets me mad.
You know what I'm saying? Ooh. One of them, he
one
was
of them
cheating on. Yeah, he was
one
cheating on his wife. The other one, you know, he's trying to be celibate and he's a pastor, but now he's slipping back. So.
But I bet the white guy is like, oh man, you could bet your money on the bank that he's gonna be friggin' upright.
He got money.
Oh yeah, wonder. Yeah, everything. He
and
got
he's
money.
So gentle
he's
and kind.
Yeah, he never cheats. He never. Yeah. Yeah, he's the upstanding. Tyler Perry did that with another show called, oh God, If Loving You Is Wrong. And ooh, girl, that was trashy. But Brad was an ex-Marine and, you know, just a stand-up, you know, guy. And yeah, you really couldn't help but love Brad because he was the hero. But Tyler Perry wrote him as the hero. Now, what's up with you, Tyler Perry, that you don't see black men in a respectable form? Sorry, I'm just asking.
No, and that's cool. And you know what? I wanna tell back on that because one of the things is he does have this other one called Bruh. Okay, and it's about four brothers.
Okay,
it's kind of a parallel to sisters. They're all successful, but again, it's like one of them just is a compulsive cheater, can't get his life right.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
One of them, he gonna sleep with a nurse. Now he had a sexual harassment. I mean, like, we're some solid families. Like,
why can't it be like the brothers in This Is Us, right? The brother in, but then again, here's the other connotation. Mm-hmm. He was raised by good white people. So, you know, like, at the end of the day.
Oh, wait. Let's talk about A Million Little Things.
Okay.
I love this show. What I love about it is they're all very close friends.
Yeah.
And they're Hispanic, white, black, but they're all very close friends. But then they have the brother who's a little bit more on the feminine side.
Interesting.
He doesn't have the... And I'm not, okay, let's not talk about masculine, what is it called?
Yeah.
What is it called?
Masculine versus feminine.
Yeah,
or femininity.
We're not, what is masculine toxicity. Mm-hmm. I'm not talking about that. I'm just saying, like, he just doesn't have that
He's not tough.
He's a very soft brother. And he's suffering from depression and he doesn't express, I mean, it's just.
Oh my goodness.
I'm like, what? I mean, listen. I'm old school. I ain't gonna lie. I like that good old fashioned. And we ain't talking about the masculine toxicity, man. That you don't have no rights. But I like that chivalry. I like you, BKT. I like a manly man.
So do you think they do that because it's such a blended cast, if you will, that, oh, if he's in a group of white friends and all of this, and he's not that kind of brother that you were just talking about, that it has to be the softer and more, oh, and all of those things to even be accepted in that friend group? I'm just asking
questions. No, that's a very
good question. I'm just asking questions.
Let's talk about that. So this goes back when we talked about a while back about how we... code switch.
Yes.
How we code switch.
Yes.
Because if you're too, you know.
Yeah.
In my former job, there were people that I didn't know that were afraid to come to me because they were intimidated by me.
You're too black.
Oh no. I was very professional. I was kind. I was sweet. I was nice. I laughed all the time. But they were intimidated by me when it came to conflict. So they were scared I was going to be
too black.
So and that's a disturbing thing, and I don't see anything wrong with learning how to culturally learn people's conversations and communications, but to be put in a stigma that I gotta put a gentleman to kind of balance out this whole show because we don't want him too assertive.
Well,
you know? And that's disturbing to me.
I remember me and Laudio share a friend, Michael Peters, who is a brilliant actor and also a man of stature. Mm. He is not a small man by any means. Mm-hmm. And I remember us talking about how basically even approaching someone when they had a flat tire, mm-hmm. how they would bristle up and be afraid, and that he had to learn how to be overly polite and be overly nice and be overly calm mm-hmm. and overly all of these things just to calm people down and for them to know, oh, big black man's not a threat, right. you know? So I do think that that goes on just yeah. to be, you know, accepted and all those things. Depending on where you're at and how you're growing up and all of that, you know. And again, it's not always the individual's fault or that they're faking. It's just you got to get by, right? Yeah. I mean, when I was growing up, like I said, in the barrio, it wasn't so much like I hated my skin or anything like that. I hated the fact that I was always different and I was always sticking out. I hated the fact that every time that I walked in, I was the only one that looked like me. Mm-hmm. And I had to figure out ways to make people like me and ways to fit in. Mm-hmm. And part of that was comedy. Part of that was being a clown, you know. Oh, they're going to be with me if I can make them laugh. But those were things that I had to do to just feel acceptance. And I know there's a lot of Americans that do that because they're in communities or whatever where they're not understood or whatever. And it'll happen in college. It can mm-hmm. happen at different stages in your life. So, yeah. So
mm-hmm. I mean, and we all go through it. It's everybody experiences this as well. But I love that we're getting more leads. I love yes. that we have the avenues to tell our own story. But on mainstream, it's still not where it should be. Even with, what was that one show? Jane the Virgin.
Ooh.
Did you watch Jane the Virgin?
I watched the first season.
Okay,
yeah.
But you know what?
I do.
Love
I
that show. Loved she it. Loved, she had the family, she had the culture. Yeah. But who is she going to marry?
A white man.
Why can't we be with our own? Don't get me wrong. I am not anti interracial relationships. Trust me, I'm not. Okay, I played in the snow quite a few times. That's not what I'm saying, but I'm just saying, why can't we see more of yes. us in our own? There's nothing wrong with what, if you know, if you're black and you're married to a white person.
Right.
You know, there's nothing wrong, but can we project a little bit more of that, of our culture, our individual cultures, like the Asians and the Hispanics right. and, I mean, I do see, when you see the Italians, they always with their own.
Yeah.
And when they're with somebody who's not with their own, mm-hmm. ooh-wee, it's a big one. It's yeah. a big deal.
Sure, sure, sure.
And there's nothing wrong with wanting to just have a solid foundation. Trust me. I love that they're being, what do you call it, conscious casting. And yeah, they're starting to be a little bit more conscious casting and putting more people. But when you're doing conscious casting, make sure you're presenting the right image.
Well, and it's also, it goes deeper to, and America just has such a long history of whitewashing and painting it as white is right. Mm-hmm. You know, white is right. If yeah. you get with the white guy, you're going to have a better life. If oh. you get with the white woman, mm-hmm. you're going to have, you know, your children are going to have a better life. You know, these messages are kind of subliminally set, but we get them through our media and through the TV shows that we watch and the commercials that we watch and all of those things. So it's like, when do we see like the Huxtables back in the 80s?
Thank you.
You know, that kind of thing. That, you know, these people, there's nothing wrong with them. They're educated. They can hold it down. Mm-hmm. They have a loving family. Why can't we see more of that? And I'm mixed race. I am happy to see mm-hmm. that finally mm-hmm. in 45 being depicted on national TV, right? Because for years, there was never a mixed person on, well, never admitted. Of course, right. they were there, but they
oh,
were,
they
put
were
in their
there.
Box. They were put in their box, right?
Oh, yeah.
Of where they fit. So to see shows like Mixed-ish and, mm-hmm. and to see commercials that are actually showing interracial families, it is refreshing to me because I always felt like an outcast, if you will. So I love that.
Yeah.
But you also need to balance it by showing positive images of Asian families, of Latin families, of black families, mm-hmm. and not just, you know, the blended families, but, you know, all of them together.
Yeah.
I've finally been seeing some interracial homosexual commercials, oh. so that's been interesting.
We love
too,
that too.
You know?
Like
so,
if
yeah.
that's what you're,
so the
LGBTQ that supports the
representation.
Yeah.
It's needed, right? And positive mm-hmm. images of yeah. what those relationships look like yeah. because they're so love takes so many different forms, right?
That's
it's
true.
Never in a box.
I'm going to touch on that in just a second, but I do. When you said that white was right, they did. That's something that you really, I love that you targeted, because like people like Sammy Davis Jr., mm-hmm. Harry Belafonte, Dante, mm-hmm. Eartha Kitt, all these women and men married opposite race, white race, because that was to help their career. Mm-hmm. So then now what you're projected is like, I'm going to marry out to advance my career, but what happened to the love and what happened to love as the foundation of a relationship and building a relationship and a legacy? And now you're marrying someone because you want to advance your career. So we're still projecting that on the screen, but in subtle ways. And mm-hmm. then when you said the LGBTQ plus, okay, so I have friends who are in the LGBTQ plus who said, oh, wow, I'm tired of just seeing us on the screen. We're glad we're being recognized, but they're still not recognizing them as a positive light. Mm-hmm. They're recognizing mm-hmm. them as, oh, they're just over flamboyant and they sleep and they go to bars and they just have sex with anybody. They're mm-hmm. floozies. But no one like, okay, I just happen to be a lawyer. Yes, and I'm gay. And I I'm a doctor. Yes, I'm gay. They have them in this extreme other box mm-hmm. that they put them in. And there's so many dynamics that can advance them too. So that as well, again, when we're talking about diversity, yes, when we're talking about diversity, we want diversity, but are you just pacifying us and just putting us in there and still keeping us in a negative connotation? Yeah, it's one thing to be a lead, but I'm still playing a drug dealer lead.
Right, exactly.
You're not helping us.
Exactly. You know? That's such a good point. And there have been some really positive things that have happened. I know, I'm glad that you brought up the LGBTQ plus community mm-hmm. because I know one of my favorite shows recently was Pose. Mm-hmm. And in Pose, there was a large cast of color, transgender, mm-hmm. You know, things that we just really haven't seen represented on the big screen or on the small screen. And but it's refreshing mm-hmm. and it's good to see that you know, these people are there, they matter, their stories matter. We want to hear them. So, you know, so it's kudos to the industry for trying.
Right.
We haven't gotten there yet, but kudos for trying and giving it a best effort. We want a few more.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm all about entertainment. Because not everything wants to be all fluffy and butterflies. Mm-hmm. I like drama. I like dirt. I like, you know, garbage sometimes. Mm-hmm. You know, however, but on the flip side, let's get some positive role models. And it's not always the white man saving the day. It can be a brother. It could be an Asian. You know, I loved all the Jackie Chan movies. Oh my God.
Oh, yeah.
Or the Jet Li movies. I want some positive role models in leads that are the heroes that are saving the day, especially in action film. Yes, thank you for the diversity. And we just want to make sure you're not diversity pacifying us at the same time.
Yes, absolutely.
You have any additional remarks?
You know, I think I said it earlier, you know, love takes all kinds of different shapes and forms and knows no bounds. And a heart's made for love, not for hate. So, you know, get out there and love somebody. And, yeah, thank you for stopping through and watching us because we love you back.
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah, so again, our show is Diversity Pacification. We want to see more of everybody in positive light.
Yes.
So we want to say thank you, everybody, for sliding through. Remember, you don't have to be asleep to dream, so get up and get out and do something for yourself. I'm Latios Muhammad, an actor with purpose.
And I'm Raven Moon, an actor with passion.
And we are actors
from the dark side.